I bought the Fujifilm X-T4 for its IBIS, and today we are going to look at how it performs against the X-T3. First and foremost, this is the setup I am using for all the tests without gimbal. The lenses used are the 10-24mm on the X-T4 and the 18-55mm on the X-T3. They were both set up at around 18mm focal length. A small note before we start, the image settings are identical or should be almost identical. The difference of quality may be due to the lens or one of the filters, so do not pay attention to it. For the first test, I am hand-holding both cameras and comparing the X-T4 with only IBIS against the X-T3. I am just walking normally and not trying to really stabilize my footstep, so I am not doing the ninja walk at all. If you're interested by the ninja walk test, keep watching until the end. In this test, I am trying to hold the two cameras as steady as possible with my arms. Having the IBIS helps a lot to minimize all the micro jitters that you get while walking. However, you can still definitely feel that I am taking each of my steps. With my current weight, it is normal that you can feel it. This is the running test. When running, I can definitely see that the video of the X-T4 doesn't shake as bad as the X-T3. The next part, we will be looking at the performance of the IBIS when panning or tilting. The micro shakes are definitely reduced on the X-T4 compared to the X-T3. I would say that being able to remove these mini shakes is one of the main advantages of having the IBIS. IBIS alone can't replace a gimbal. You would need to make sure that you have a steady footstep to have a stabilized footage, or this is what you would get. Now, let's add on the digital image stabilization and we will look at how it performs with the same test. With the digital image stabilization, my heavy step is quite toned down. This is especially visible when I am running. Let me show you how it looks like with and without on the X-T4. In case you haven't noticed yet, there is a crop factor of 1.1 when you activate the digital image stabilization. And if you're shooting at 60fps, you will get a crop factor of 1.29. This is the third test where we will activate the image stabilization boost. It is normally recommended for static shot only, but we will do the same test as before and let's see how it looks like. Now, let's have a look at how the IBIS on the X-T4 performs against the X-T3 on a gimbal, the DJI Ronin SC. Thank you. having the IBs and doing the ninja walk gives you an almost gimbal-like feeling. The downside is that you have to work your legs to make it work, and if the path is uneven, you may not get the same result. With the digital image stabilizer, we are really close to the gimbal level. And if you take your time, I'm pretty sure that you can even do better than me at the ninja walk. It says that the image stabilizer boost is mainly for static shot, but I find that even while walking, it helps to stabilize, giving a 99% stability compared to the gimbal, the DJI Vernon AC. It's not surprising that the X-T4 is definitely better for video stabilizing than the X-T3 with its IBIS. The main question is, you need to ask yourself whether you need the IBIS or not. It is definitely a good addition to have the IBIS on the X-T4, especially when you don't want to carry a gimbal around. In terms of mobility, it is definitely a big plus. However, if what you're looking for is a buttery smooth footage, you should get the gimbal instead.